This video is made for anyone who's working hard to become a UX designer. Today, I'm going to talk about how to make your first UX portfolio. I'm Aliana, I'm a self-taught UX designer, and welcome back to my channel! First of all, in today's industry standard, your UX portfolio should be a shareable link that's presented in your resume, and it should be a digital website where people can view your case studies. In today's video, we'll be focusing on building the homepage of the portfolio. Well, let's start with some common mistakes to avoid, because I've made all these mistakes before, and please don't make the same mistake. The first thing that I don't see a lot of people talk about is rushing through choosing a website builder and start building your portfolio even when you don't have all the assets ready. Assets mean the visual of the portfolio, the banner of each case study. If you skip one step in the UX process, then have you tried to fill in the gap and just write down that step? Usually, for your first job, you will need 3 case studies. At least one of them shall be a real-life project, which means you've worked with actual client or did a collaboration among a group of designers and engineers and work within design constraint. So please do all of those before jumping into, you know, thinking about, I'm going to get this portfolio out there. Another common mistake is skipping the feedback. You know, as UX designers, we understand the importance of gathering user feedback. But that's the same when it comes to our own portfolio. So instead of just like stir into your portfolio the entire day and try to make it better, what you can do is send it to 3 of your friends and ask for feedback, and they will directly tell you what they think. Another very, very common mistake and very problematic mistake I see among people is unprofessional visual. I know some of you don't like the UI side of things, but if you want to become a UX designer, you still need to have decent UI skills. And a lot of jobs are UI UX designers these days. So having professional visual design is super important. And if you want to check out more on that, I've had this video here. Now, on the other hand of things, some people have really good visual presentation, but no explanation. This is another problem, especially if you came from, you know, a more traditional design background. You might have a really good looking poster, but there's nothing explaining the process. Now, when it comes to a UX portfolio, you need to make sure that you explain through how you make certain design decisions. Now, let's jump right into how to build our first UX portfolio. The first step is to design the structure of your homepage, and I highly recommend you to sketch this out on paper. So the first recommendation is this structure. Now the benefit of this structure is that it showcases 4 projects. Another one that I recommend is this structure, and this one showcases only 3 projects. So if you have 3 projects, you can go with this one. But as you can see, everything's simple. You don't have to go with like a crazy design or a super creative design. It's actually way better if you go with like a simple design. Please select one. And now let's move to our second step. The second step is simply to decide which case study are you going to choose and present on your portfolio and in which order. Now, usually we go with like a chronological order, but my suggestion is that for the first case study, it has to be the best one that we're going to present in the interview, a real life project, a collaborative project, and a project you're proud of. The other 3 or the other 2 projects can be your personal project. And once you have that ready, please just fill them out. I just filled mine out. I simply name it based on the product name that I work for. In the top left will be the project that I will highlight. By the way, some of these are fictional projects that I've never done before, but I need to have it here because I couldn't present what I did in my previous startup here. But you shouldn't make things up. Yeah. Now, let's jump to the third step. This step is to sketch out the banner of each project. And I will present something here. Ta-da! So for my Kiss app, I sketch out 2 app interface look because it is an app. And for my Shadow a Student Challenge, it is a web design, so I did like a web design look. And for the Mamo book, it is a responsive web, so 1 desktop, 1 mobile. And then for Google internship, if it's like a brand like Google, everyone knows it, then you can just put a Google logo in the middle. Now the key is that you need to design this look based on how they work beside each other, you know? So let's say if I decided to go with a more complicated view, like present 5 interfaces for the Kiss app, And I probably should go with something simpler on the right side, which is the shadow student one. And the weight of these design all matters. That's why you should design it side by side, just to have a structure in mind. These banners are, you know, what get you into the door of this entire industry. If you want more inspiration when it comes to how to design a banner, please check out cofolios.com. This is a website that showcases a lot of successful UX portfolio. Now let's go to the first step, and I will take you through how I design the banner of my portfolio. Let's go to Figma. Let's start with building a frame. The dimension I'm using right now is 1000 times 600, and I will give it a name based on the project. Then I'm going to drag the user interface I want to present into this frame. They are super large, so let's adjust the size to fit it into the screen. Now let's take a look at the sketch that I did before. It is two of the screens on the bottom. However, I see that if I do something like this, I will be blocking some of the key design. I decided to go with something one up and one down, something more like this. Now for the next step, we're going to select a mockup for our iPhone. The way to do that is to go to Explore Community page on Figma and then type in iPhone mockup. For today, I will choose the flight iPhone mockup. You can duplicate it to use it. Usually, it will give you a little bit of instruction. So here it says paste your design here. I already copied it. Now I'm going to paste it here and adjust the size to fit this mockup. After pasting it, ta-da! It's reflected over here. And some of the templates also allow you to change the color of the mobile. So for this one, I'm double clicking it, selecting the body to change my mobile color into a white color. I didn't go with the black color because I think the black color is a little bit too strong on the visual and I want to highlight what is in the content. So once this is done, we can select the frame that we want and then export it over here. I usually go with something higher than what I need. We do the same for the other one, and then we replace what we have here with the new design that we have. Now what we can do is to choose a background for the banner. And usually how I choose a background is I start with the main color of my design. And I slowly move it to something that's lighter. Oh, and I think that's gonna be okay. Yeah, and that looks good. And the same happens to all of my other design. For Shadow a Student, I will quickly take you through how I did, you know, this kind of shadowy thing on the back over here, because this is super important. Don't go with a drop shadow. Instead of doing a drop shadow, what I suggest you to do is simply create another rectangle. And this rectangle should be the area you want the shadow to be in. And then you can change the color into dark black and then go with 30% of opacity, and then go to effects and then choose layer blur. Click this sunny icon and adjust the blur to something like 30 or 40 or 50, whatever you see fit, and then move this layer underneath the original bigger layer and adjust it if needed. For example, I can make it a little bit lower to 20. And what this does is that it gives you a little bit more of a floating visual. Now remember that good design comes with iteration. So if the first trial, it doesn't look good for you, just keep iterating until like a combination look really professional. Now let's go to the next step, which is preparing the text that we will need for our homepage. The first section is the intro section. The second section includes your case study titles and subtitles. And finally is the footer section. Now I suggest you to use Grammarly to prepare all this text, just because you don't want to make a spelling error or a grammar error in your homepage. Now let me run you through how to actually build our portfolio on a website and view it on a website. So in this case, I recommend you to use three platforms. If you're not on a tight budget, maybe use Squarespace, because Squarespace will give you a customized domain, which is yourname.com. Otherwise, you can also use Behance and Notion. Behance and Notion will also do the work. And today, I'm just going to take you through how I use Squarespace to build out the homepage of a portfolio. Let's first go to Squarespace. You can also try this out without really paying anything. So I'm just going to teach you how to do that. Go to Get Started once you landed on Squarespace. And then it will ask you to choose a template. Click Portfolio on the top left. And then go to Photography. Scroll down and then choose a very simple template that resembles the styles you design. For me, I'm going to go with Bellboy. Click Start with Bellboy. Change the site title to your name. Continue. Close. Before we go into design anything, I suggest you to do the following settings just to preview your website without really signing up to Squarespace. Go to Settings. Go to Site Availability. Set it to Password Protected. And then click Upgrade to Publish. Go back to Settings. Go to Domains, click this thing here, and then change the site ID to your name. Now let's go back and change everything we need to the homepage, starting with the header. For the header, go to Pages, and then you will see Main Navigation. Main Navigation is what will appear on your header. The template has Work, but I'm going to delete Work. Click Setting, and then Delete Folder. We can keep the About page and we can design that later. And then for the Instagram, I will click the setting and change it to LinkedIn. For you, you should definitely paste in your LinkedIn link here. I'm not going to do so because I don't want to expose my LinkedIn link. Save. Now we can see that it becomes Aliena's High About and LinkedIn. Ta-da! The second step, let's change the text and content for the body part. Go to what we prepared before, the intro statement that we have, and then paste it here. Double click it, paste it here. Now, when you paste something to Squarespace or any website, it probably wouldn't look the way you want it to look. So there are a few things you can change things around. First, it should break paragraph into two paragraphs. Second is to change the heading style to something smaller, to bold it, to unbold it. Change things around to make sure everything looks good on your side. And for me, this looks better than what it had before. Now, for the body part, the template already provides you a lot of sections, but you don't need them because we already designed ours. So just delete everything. Don't worry, you don't need these. Remove. After we removed every section that we don't need, let's add section. Click Add Blank. Click the Add button, choose Image, and then upload all the image we designed in the previous step. Don't forget to download them first. And please make sure it's high resolution. After you upload it, you should be able to see it here. Let's click Add button again and then add all the other images. Once you are done with adding the images, you can now drag things around. For example, I want to place my second image to here. That's why I'm dragging it to here, and the fourth image beside the third image. And ta-da! There's like big structure ready on the portfolio. Now let's add the text to it. Add text box by clicking the plus sign again, text, and copy it from whatever you prepared. You probably need to adjust the style a little bit to make it work. And I usually add an extra line into each of my text box so that it looks good on the mobile version. Let's add the text for the other projects as well. And make sure we change the style to align with what we did for the first project. Sometimes there will be like extra text box that just provided by Squarespace, but you don't need those, so we can just remove those. And now for the footer. What we need to do for the footer is that we can swap it to a really simple one. We can remove it first and then we add section and choose like the centered aligned simple one. Here we go. Social links, we don't need those. We can delete those. And then we use the text that we prepared in the footer section here. For me, it's just 2022 Alienas had all rights reserved. Save. Click done, save. Now let's go to a guest account and then put in the domain name. Ta-da! If the content looks right, we can do the final step, which is adjusting the visual of the portfolio. Now usually on Squarespace, the text, the fonts, everything's set up by their designer, so everything should be good. But sometimes, let's see, for the description of my project, I want it to appear a little bit bigger. So what I can do is go to Set Styles, Fonts. I can click here and then it will just automatically give me what I used. I know I was using paragraph 2 for the description. I wanted to be a little bit bigger, so I will set it to 1.1 instead of 1. Ta-da! And it's getting a little bit bigger. So you can do some little adjustment here that can be helpful. Another thing we can adjust is go back to here, styles. There's spacing. And we can add some more space margin to the portfolio, for example, 5. If we save it now and then we refresh this page, ta-da, there's going to be more space margin on the side. And then it looks good. So that is how I built my homepage for my portfolio. And I hope this video helps some of you. For the next step, it will be actually creating the case study connecting to each of these case and also linking the image and the text to the case study page. That will be for my next video. So stay tuned and I hope you learned something from this video. I shot this video 4 times already because my camera just keep dying. Anyways, my camera is dying again. So see you next time. Have a good day. Goodbye.